Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis.
Here we can see the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis muscle highlighted in green. Some muscles close by to it are the palmaris longus muscle and the flexor carpi radialis. The flexor digitorum superficialis has a close relationship to the flexor digitorum profundus muscle. Let's take a closer look at that next. Here we can see the flexor digitorum superficialis by itself, and I just want you to take a look at the distal tendons of this muscle, and you'll notice that there's a little hole here on each of these distal tendons. And these holes are for the flexor digitorum profundus muscle to pass through, and you can see here how the profundus is passing through that gap we just saw, connecting onto the tip of the finger, also known as the distal phalanges. And now you can see the flexor digitorum profundus muscle by itself. If you'd like to learn more about this muscle, I'll put a link in the description box below to the flexor digitorum profundus muscle video. Next, you can see the origin points highlighted in red here. Let's take a look at the first one. That's on the medial epicondyle of the humerus. One thing to note about this origin point is that it's via the common flexor tendon. And the common flexor tendon is made up of the tendons of five muscles: the flexor digitorum superficialis, flexor carpi ulnaris, palmaris longus, flexor carpi radialis, and the pronator teres. And the tendons of those five muscles are all going to merge into that common flexor tendon, so they're all going to share the same tendon essentially, which connects onto the medial epicondyle of the humerus. Just below that medial epicondyle, you can see our next origin point, which is the coronoid process of the ulna. So coronoid process of the ulna would be this section of the ulna, which I'm moving my cursor around right here. Obviously this is the ulna, this is the radius. And that's going to bring us on to our next origin point here, which is on the radius, and that's going to be on the proximal half of the anterior border of the radius. Due to the arrangement of these origins, this muscle is considered to have two heads. We've got the humeroulnar head here, connecting the humerus and the ulna, and then we've got the radial head here, connecting onto the radius. Moving down towards the fingers now, you can see the insertion point, and you can see them marked out here in blue. And that insertion point is going to be on the middle phalanges, or the intermediate phalanges, depending on which you want to call them. So these bones of the fingers are divided into different sections based on where the joints are. So this would be the distal phalanges, then we've got those middle phalanges, the proximal phalanges, and the metacarpals. So notice how the flexor digitorum superficialis doesn't cross this joint here on the tip of the finger, so it won't have any action on the tips of the fingers moving at the distal interphalangeal joint.
So let's take a look at the actions next. Now the primary action of the flexor digitorum superficialis is to flex the fingers, but let's take a look at that in a little bit more detail.
Here you can see flexion of the fingers being performed, and on the right hand side you can see all the bones of the fingers colour coordinated and their respective joints are labelled as well. Now one thing to note about the flexor digitorum superficialis is that it can't flex the distal interphalangeal joint, and that's the joint at the tip of the finger, and the reason for that is because it doesn't cross this joint, so it has no way of acting on it. Due to this, when it flexes the fingers, that flexion is going to occur at the proximal interphalangeal joint and the metacarpophalangeal joint. Now its primary action is flexion of the fingers, but because it crosses the wrist, it's able to provide some weak assistance during flexion of the wrist as well.
So if you've enjoyed the video or you find it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, let me know what you thought of the video in the comment. It really helps out the channel. Thanks again for watching everyone. See you all next time.